So give it up for DC's very own Martin Phillips!
Martin had a dream. Martin had a dream. Kendrick have a dream.
I ruined that guy's life. Like, he saw me, and you know, like, and when he told me that, I was like, man, I'm old as fuck. Thanks. I have a terrible influence on people, but I'm happy he got me on his show, and is paying me, so it's cool. I don't care. Okay. Next joke. Let's see, are you guys watching the WNBA playoffs? Make some noise. Woo! I don't believe you, but, you know, we can all pretend. But, you know, I don't know if you know this, but actually, there's a team, they're called the Indiana Fever. I don't know about you, but that sounds like something you don't want to catch. You know, it's like, oh gross. Oh, shit. Fucking cicadas everywhere. Don't fuck up my set. That was a great joke. What if I ate it? No, I'm not gonna do that. That's gross. I don't like bugs. Man, these don't die. Now I have to do it to get it out of its misery, you know? It's still alive. Like, how is it?
Still alive.
Okay,
still alive. You
should. Okay, we know. Well, I value life, okay? And so. It can still be alive as we watch it suffer and cripple itself along the stage. Again, so I gotta focus. Man, those things just don't die. Jesus. That's why they come out every 17 years. Okay, next joke. Okay. Well, I'm trying to say Indiana Fever. That sounds like where you date too many trashy white girls, right? Like, man, Steve hangs out by the trailer park too much. Okay. It was worth it. That long break in between jokes was worth it. Man, I don't know if it is alive or plain dead. Okay, next joke. I went out with this girl I met on a dating app. I never saw her again, but that's not the point in the story. A few days later, I saw that she had changed her entire profile, like new pictures, new bio. It's like after going out with me, she was like, I'm attracting the wrong type of man, you know? Like, I'm better than this, you know? And I'm not upset because, you know, I helped her realize her full potential. So I changed her life. I'm part of the narrative, you know? I'm there when Susan got her shit together. So thanks to this guy. Bada boom. Okay, now I did speed dating once. That's when you take a bunch of methamphetamine and go on a date, and you're pretty out of your mind, but you leave an impression. So, bada boom. Okay, next joke. I transition well, man. I think it is dead. It's been staying in that position for like 3 minutes now. I think. And you can still hear that, man, that motherfucker's fine, man. I hate cicadas. They're just gross looking, man. Okay. Next joke. You're right. I went out with this other girl once, and she was from Bangladesh. It was, like, in college. And she said once she graduates, she either has to find a job or get married. And I said, man, you better start looking for that job now. Don't rely on your bully, okay? Because ain't about that life. Okay. The drunkest I've ever been was at a wedding. Because then at that event, I had the bouquet and I was eating it. People were like, man, that guy is fucked up. Or they thought, I guess it was hungry, you know? Like, there are not many vegetarian options, and he had to, like, eat what he could, so. I don't know, my parents told me how they met, and it's very unsettling, you know? Apparently my dad, they lived in the same apartment building, he knocked on my mom's door and said, hey, you left your car lights on, don't worry, I turned them off. Not only did he break into her car, he knew what car was hers. And he knew what apartment building she lived in. And they had been married for 3 decades, so. The 80s were different, I guess. And you know what, they met when they were both in their 30s, so. I'm sure they were both like, guess this is the end of the line. There's nothing else coming, I guess. Gotta make the best with this psycho who broke into my car. And I can't go to the phone for advice, you know? My dad would be like, yeah, just follow her home. It's like, no, dude. My mom would be like, yeah, just have you threatened her life yet? And it's like, where do I come from, you know? And my grandparents, the only reason why they got married is because they were the only two people that lived on the same dirt road. It's like, they didn't settle. They just didn't even try. They're just like, you're the only member of the opposite sex I've ever met. You know, so, it's about, I don't know. But you know, I've always had trouble with women. When I was in second grade, this girl in my class, she showed me her nipple, and I told the teacher, so it's, you know, that was a day, you know, I decided who I was going to be in life, and I took the road less traveled, you know, like, I could have been cool. Oh shit, it's gone, I guess it was a life, okay. Let's see, you guys, you guys like to gamble, man? You guys like to take risks? Yeah, I heard someone who, yeah. There was this guy in gambling debt, he couldn't pay, so they killed him. Now, I was like, I don't get the point of that. That's just a bit excessive, you know? Like, you still don't have your money, you know? It's like, you're gonna max out this guy's credit cards or something. That's why, if I was in charge, what I would do, I would kick in the door and be like, hey, asshole, fill out these job applications, okay? You know, dress up nice, you have an interview at 2, you know? You're making this money back. You're gonna learn financial responsibility. God damn it, so. Cool, let's see. I heard good-looking people hang out with other good-looking people. So I looked at all my friends. I was like, this all makes sense now. The universe brought us together. Right? Okay. Hey, I'm better looking that way. But the crazy thing is, like, none of us get laid. Okay. And that's why I have orgies, right? When I first heard the word orgy, I thought it meant like two or more oranges, you know, like a group. So yeah, I got an orgy at the market, it's at the table. Okay, last joke, get ready for it. I'm gonna deconstruct that cicada. I'm gonna open it up. No, I heard this story, I don't know if it got surfaced, but Disneyland, there's a bit, it's controversy. They're upset on the Snow White ride, because the prince he kisses Snow White when she was asleep. But that's not true. We all know she ate the poison apple. She's dead, right? Like, it's not Like, you know, like, consent doesn't exist if, like, you don't, right? You know? You know, I wanted to write more to that joke, but I figured after a while you guys would just think like, man, I think this guy wants to fuck a dead body. I don't know, this guy sounds really passionate, you know? And I'm just like, yeah, she's dead, it's a free-for-all. It's gonna spoil. I don't know why he kisses her, right? Like, if I was there, I'd be like, hey, I'm a prince. I can do better, right? Like, she, you know, some lady tries to kill her. She got animal in her house. She's got all these guys. Like, man, this is white trash, right? Cool. Well, I should go. So I could have done a better joke, but it's been rad. So rock on. See ya.
Amazing, amazing. World class. You're a good influence. You're a good influence, Martin. Trust me. Trust me.